Hi, I'm Kieran O'Neill and this is Bracken Boxing Club. Okay, Eric, we're here with you in Bracken Boxing Club in the clubhouse here, and I have with me is Greg Kenny, founder member of the club 40 years ago, and I've Glenn Wybrus, who is now the chairman and president of the club. Glenn also boxed for us, but he's back coach.
Yes.
I came here to the club in 1985. When I came, Greg was 40 years of age, and I'm now that age. So, you know, we're 20 years together. A lot of managers wouldn't have lasted that long, but we're still getting on, Greg, aren't we?
Certainly.
I think we're going to stick it out for a little while.
10 years,
anyway. We've a tremendous history here. When we first came here, this was a concrete floor, it was rafters. One time we were put out, but it was a big campaign to actually buy the premises, which that was a phenomenal achievement at the time. I think we bought the premises around 87. But if you bear in mind, when Kenny Egan got a silver medal in Beijing, they were training there for skewing. We had a lot of initial success. We all brought an All-Ireland deal, won an All-Ireland title in 1986. The normal run of losing the finals, including myself, losing an Indonesia final, fellas like Sean McMahon, and we seemed to hit the bar for a long period of time. And then we had a 13 year gap outside of Irish national honours. And then Gerard Whitehouse got to an Irish final, and the second year he won the title, and he brings a 22 year gap. Robert Gorman won an Irish Indonesia title, a fabulous night in the national stadium. He came behind. We thought he was getting very himself at Glenn on the corner that night, and he lifted the roof that night. He went on, he got five Irish senior international vests. Whitehouse got four or five, and O'Reilly got the same. And then we've Chloe Graves has just got her first international vest, and then we've Dennis Gifford. This club is funded by the people. It's totally voluntary. Everybody in this club is a volunteer. There's no one in a paid position here. Future with the club, there's one thing we haven't done. We've sent a number of boxers away to the European Champions. We've never got a boxer to the World Champions. That's something that sits to us, it kind of bothers us. We lost a lot of tight decisions, and there was a few funny selections from the national stadium, but we had to accept them. So we'd like to get a boxer to the World Champions. Any amateur coach will always tell you everyone wants an Olympian, and that is the one thing that we would like to do. That's our underlying ambition, would be to send a boxer away to the Olympic Games, because the Games is the be all and end all of our sport. That's what all the great fighters went through, the Muhammad Ali's, the Oscar De La Hoya's, Teofilo Stevenson, they've all braced the Games. So we believe here that if we keep going at the vein that we're going at the moment and the standard of our competing, that we can break show and send a boxer to the Olympic Games, which would be fabulous to have the fourth Olympian in Balbriggan. Imagine what that would do. We get a lot of sponsorship then, hopefully. The club will be forever grateful. Like Greg is, and people like Martin Shute and Bridge Shute, who's now deceased, his wife, Brendan Portal. So many people to mention that have put all the fundamentals in place now that we own this building. The club has been here for 14 years now, and these people have secured the future of the club, that we can give an offer to this community for another 40 years. And we look forward to that. We've had a 20 year anniversary now, and we hope to see us now on the 60 year one.